of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Cougars. Welcome to SCTV News for Thursday, October 17th. I'm Andrew Ray.
And I'm Aline Contreras. Thank you to all staff and students who helped make yesterday's lockdown drill a success. We have another emergency drill after today's edition of SCTV News at 10:17. We will join thousands of California students in an earthquake drill called the Great California Shakeout. Make sure you follow your teacher's instructions to make sure today's drill is a success.
We are only 2 days away from Future Fest at Cuyamaca College. All students are invited to visit this Saturday from 9 a.m. to noon. If you've never been to Cuyamaca College, their campus is less than 10 minutes away from our school. Future Fest is a great opportunity to meet representatives from several local colleges, military branches, and trade schools. There are also workshops to help you with things like financial aid and other college and career topics. If you're free on Saturday morning, stop by and plan for your future.
Senior merch has arrived. Cougar Senior can now pick up their class of 25 apparel. There are a variety of items available, all with the senior class color, which is green. You'll find a link in the bio on the senior class Instagram page. Not only will you have a keepsake from your senior year, but you'll be helping put this year's senior prom, so check out the store and grab some merch today.
We have a food update from the cafeteria. The cookies, chips, and Snapple that used to be available at the lunch carts are now located at the cafeteria windows. In addition, students are encouraged to check out the line at the Red Cougar Cube. Right now, the White Cube has been experiencing longer wait times, so if you'd like to check out your food faster, check out the Red Cube in the East Quad.
We're a little more than 1 week away from our fall blood drive. The date is next Friday, October 25th. You must be at least 17 years old and 110 pounds to donate. If you meet those requirements, you can sign up right now through a link on our school website, and everyone who donates receives a $5 gift card and a ticket to the Hollow Scream event at SeaWorld.
You're running out of time to purchase a Pink Out box from our Pink Ribbon Club. You can order using this QR code, and it'll be delivered next week. The cost is $20. And inside, you'll find pink-colored items to show your support in the fight against breast cancer. So, add some pink to your wardrobe and fight against breast cancer today.
The weather just starting to cool down this fall, but Cougar athletes had to deal with some extremely high temperatures in August and September. In fact, there are new rules in places as it relates to sports and the weather. Yusuke Murofushi explains.
There is a new rule in sports this year. It's about the weather and when athletes can play based on the weather. So let's ask coaches and Dr. Cohen about the rule.
We can practice normal as long as the wet bulb is under 79.7 degrees. If it goes up to 84.6, we just have to use discretion and provide extra water breaks. Then up to 87.6, we can have a 2 hour practice, and again, those extra water breaks. Up to 89.6, we can have a 1 hour practice and a lot of water breaks, and we can't use any pads or extra equipment in football. But if it gets greater than 89.8 degrees on the wet bulb, then we have to cancel practice altogether.
So we have a new wet bulb requirement. It has to hit a certain threshold of air quality, air temperature, to be able to have and hold practices. For us, we got moved into category 2, so that's 89.8 degrees.
Let's ask some student athletes about what they think about the rules.
It's pretty cool. It kind of sucks sometimes because it's like it's 98 degrees and I want to hop in the pool because I play water polo. But I'm sure for the football guys or the baseball guys, the guys who play outside, it's probably going to suck because it's hot, it's dry, there's like almost no air moving. But for other sports, it'd be nice because like if it gets hot, the hotter it gets, the more I want to be and play water polo and hop in the pool. But and for indoor sports, I don't think it changes much either, because I'm pretty sure our gym has AC. But other than that, I think it's an all right rule. Helps protect like the football players and the baseball players.
I think it's good because it's looking out for our safety, and it just shows that the school really cares about us and doesn't just see us as a program.
So now we know how the school will keep Steel Canyon athletes safe during games and practice. For SCTV News, I'm Yusuke Murofushi.
Attention girls soccer players. There will be a mandatory meeting today at lunch in the geography lab. Coach DeLauro will have important information about the upcoming seasons, so make plans to be in the Geo Lab at lunch.
Boys water polo is at Monte Vista today, JV at 5 and varsity at 6.
That's all the news we have for you today. Have a great week. Rah, rah, Cougars.
Cougar pride.
Get some.